Okay, today already we have discussed initial parts of the macroeconomics. Today what we are going to discuss is macroeconomics equilibrium. සාර්ව ආර්ථික සමතුලිතතාවය කියන සංකල්පය ගැන තමා අද අපි කතා කරන්න යන්නේ. Before go to the main session, I would like to revise to your knowledge regarding the macroeconomics. Already we discussed macroeconomics studies the behavior of the whole economy of a country by focusing leading economic aggregates such as national income, employment, consumption, investment, general price level, and the role of fiscal and monetary policy in the economy. When it's become microeconomics, we just concentrate on one particular unit. That means it can be a household, it can be a firm, it can be an industry. The thing is, we didn't consider whole economy. We just concentrated on one particular unit. And we evaluated the process of that particular unit. And we identified some equilibrium concepts and equilibrium conditions. But the main point is we just concentrate on one particular unit. But when it's become a macroeconomy, we are considering whole economic factors. අපි සාර්වාර්ථිකයට එනකොට ශුද්ධාර්ථිකයේදී වගේ නෙමෙයි ශුද්ධාර්ථිකයේදී අපි එක ඒකකයක් විතරයි සලකා බැලුවේ. උදාහරණයක් විදිහට ගත්තොත් එහෙම පූර්ණ තරඟකාරී වෙළඳ ව්‍යාපාරයක සමතුලිත එහෙම නැත්නම් වීවෙළඳපොලේ සමතුලිතේ එහෙම නැත්නම් කුටුම්බයක කොහොමද උපරිම තෘප්තියට ළඟා වෙන්නේ අන්න ඒ වගේ දේවල් අපි කතා කරේ වෙළඳපොලක සමතුලිත මිට සමතුලිත ප්‍රමාණය නිශ්චිත වෙළඳපොලක නමුත් අපි සාර්වාර්ථිකයට එනකොට රටේ සමස්ත ආර්ථික ඒ කියන්නේ රටේ සමස්ත නිෂ්පාදනය සමස්ත ආදායම් සමස්ත වියදම් අපි කතා කරා ගිය සතියේ අවසාන වශයෙන් කතා කරා ගිය සතියේට කලින් සතියේ ඒ කියන්නේ ගිය session එකට කලින් session එකේ රටේ සමස්ත නිෂ්පාදනය දල දේශීය නිෂ්පාදනය කොහොමද ගණනය කරන්නේ දල ජාතික නිෂ්පාදනය කොහොමද ගණනය කරන්නේ මේ ගණනය කිරීම සිදු කරන ප්‍රවේශයන් මොනවද we discussed all the things so today what we are going to discuss is macroeconomics equilibrium okay let's move forward Then this one also we discussed macroeconomic goals. Basically, we in case of a economy, we may have in some economical goals such as economic stability and growth, full employment, price stability, BOP, sustainable development, as such. When you go through the central bank reports, you can identify. If you go to the central bank website. You can identify what has done as a country to achieve these macroeconomics goals. So these days you are free. So I kindly request go to those websites and search what they have done. And what those all the information are available in the central bank website and some publications also available. You can get those things free of charge to some of those. Yes. Then economic stability, let's just read it out since we discussed. High level of production and it is sustained growth are among the most important goals of any economy. That means output level without wide fluctuations. Fluctuations may lead to a decline in the gross national product. Again, මිල මට්ටම, නිෂ්පාදන මට්ටම, ආදායම ගත්තහම ස්ථාවර මට්ටමක පවත්වා ගත යුතුයි ආර්ථිකයක් වුණහම ඒකේ ඉහළ පහළ යාම් තියෙනවා නම් ඒ කියන්නේ ඒ ආර්ථිකේ ගැටලුවක් තියෙනවා. If we go through the dollar price of Sri Lankan context, dollar price now really high and last time ඒක ගිය වුරු ගිය සතියේ වැඩි වුණා 200 දක්වා ඊට පස්සේ ආය අඩු වුණා. ඔය වගේ තත්ත්වයන් තමයි ලංකාවේ ආර්ථිකයේ තියෙන්නේ. That is not a good डॉलर प्राइस से गत्तो ते निश्चित अवमट्टम का पावत्वा गिने या युति देन व्हेन इट्स बिकम फुल एम्प्लॉयमेंट द टर्म फुल एम्प्लॉयमेंट इंक्लूड्स बोथ लेबर एंड अदर फैक्टर्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन द The idea is that in an economy, all the production factors such as land, labor, capital, entrepreneurship should be fully utilized. When it's become an economy, we may have economical factors such as land, labor, capital, and entrepreneurship, then economy, or in case of production process, economy should try to utilize the available economical resources in case of their production process as much as possible. ආර්ථික රටක් ගත්තාම රටේ ආර්ථිකය භාණ්ඩ හා සේවා නිෂ්පාදනය කරනකොට භාණ්ඩ හා සේවා නිෂ්පාදනය කිරීමේදී භාවිතා කරන සම්පත් අපි ආර්ථික සම්පත් විදිහට හඳුනා ගන්නවා. අපි ප්‍රධාන ආකාර හතරකට මේ ආර්ථික සම්පත් වර්ගීකරණය කරා භූමිය ශ්‍රමය ප්‍රාග්ධනය විවසාය කියලා. එතකොට මේ භූමිය ශ්‍රමය ප්‍රාග්ධනය විවසාය කියන ආර්ථික සම්පත් රටක් සතුව තියෙන පූර්ණ වශයෙන් භාවිතා කිරීම සාර්ව ආර්ථික ගෝල් එක. විදිහට හඳුනා ගන්න ඒක ඔයාලට පැහැදිලි. Then price stability, general price level I explained already in Sri Lankan price level. General price level can be harmful to most agents engaged in economic activities. Macroeconomics try to keep price level stable. The not mean a fixed price level that can be measured using price indicators. Already I explained this. Then BOP means balance of payment. I discussed these things in last session also. A statement that summarizes an economy's transaction with the rest of the world for a specified time period. Then the balance of payments, also known as balance of international payments, encompasses all transactions between countries' residents and non-residents involving goods and services, income and financial claims. Then this sustainable development, this is a new scenario. Before one decade back, these scenarios came into the industry. Then sustainable development is a process for meeting human development goals while sustaining ability of nature systems to continue provide the natural resources and the ecosystem services which the economy and society depends. ඒ කියන්නේ සරලව ගත්තහම අපි සංවර්ධනය කරා යනකොට පරිසරයට වෙන බලපෑම් අවමට්ටමක තබාගෙන අපි සංවර්ධන කටයුතු අත්පත් කරගන්න ඕන කියන එක තමයි මේකේ සරල අදහස. කලින් ගත්තොත් එහෙම අපි 90 දශකයට කලින් ගත්තොත් එහෙම අපේ එහෙම සංකල්පයක් තිබෙන්නේ නැහැ. නමුත් මේ පරිසර දූෂණය ඊට පස්සේ මේ වසංගත තත්ත්වයන් එනකොට ස්වභාවික ආපදා එනකොට මිනිසාගේ බලපෑම තමයි මේවට හේතු වෙලා තියෙන්නේ. එතකොට මේ නිසා අපි සංවර්ධනය අත්පත් කරගන්නවා එක්කම පරිසරයට වෙන බලපෑම අවමට්ටමක තබාගත යුතුයි කියන දේ ලෝකයක් විසින් අඳුරගෙන තියෙනවා. ඒ නිසා තමයි මේ වගේ සංකල්ප සාර්ව ආර්ථික අරමුණක් විදියට යොදාගෙන තියෙනවා. Then these things we discussed. This is the most important part in this session, today's session. When it's become an economy, it can be a two-sector economy, it can be a three-sector economy, it can be a basically a four-sector economy. Most of the practical scenarios within the world are four-sector economics today, because now we know there is a concept globalization. Technology has developed. That's why today we are meeting as like this. If not, today without having practical physical lecture sessions, we are not able to conduct these types of online sessions. Today we know technically we have developed. Then if I need, I can conduct lectures for foreigners too through using these technologies. As like that, each and every sector of the economy, they can contact foreigners as the suppliers, they can contact foreigners as the consumers, then they can work together as a, this known as whole world, as a one village අපි කියනවා විශ්ව ගම්මානයක් කියලා. එතකොට මේ විදේශ බලපෑමක් දෙනවා. Let's discuss one by one. When it becomes a simple economy, you know that to have in a business, we should have two parties. That means purchase buyers and the suppliers. Then in economy also, owners of the economical resources are people. That means households. Then businesses also owned by the households. Using these economical factors, the household that means business firms are producing goods and services. Households can provide their economical risk factors to the businesses. Then they can earn from capital. They can earn interest. Then from labor they can earn wages. Then from land they can earn rent. From entrepreneurship they can earn profits. Then after they earned through this providing economical factors to the economy, what they can do is they can use that income to purchase goods and services which was produced by the business firms of the economy. So that is the two sector economy scenario. Mama ara kalinuth kiwwa wage mage mansathuwa pavatina shramaya kiyana aarthika sampatha mama yodawala wetupa kiyana aadayam utpadanaya karanawa ita passe mage wetupa aarthikaya nishpadanaya karana baanda ha sewa miladi ganna man wiyadan karana මගේ වැටුප ගත්තාම මගේ මුළු වැටුපම මම වියදම් කරන්නේ නැහැ භාණ්ඩ හා සේවා මිලදී ගන්න මම මගේ වැටුපෙන් කොටසක් ඉතුරු කර. එතකොට එනවා සංකල්පයක් මොකද්ද වෙන්නේ ආර්ථිකයේ සංසරණය වන cash flows are reducing because of my savings. So those types of things we identified as withdrawals. The withdrawals are the things which reduce the money in the circular of cash flows. මේ මුදල අර ප්‍රවාහයෙන් පිටරටට සිදුවන දේවල් අපි කියනවා කාන්දුවීන් කියලා. In other side, I am investing my own money from that savings in business firms. Simply, let's say I am initiating my own business. That means investment. Then, when I am doing such investments, what is happening? Screen ekak andinne pa. What is happening? The cash flows, circulars are increasing. So those are known as injections. All of these, all the injections of the money circulating in the cash flows are increased. Ewa api vidim kiyala handuna ganna. When it's become two sector economy, as I explained, one withdrawal is there, that is saving. One injection also there, that is investment. Okay. Then, as simple micro economic equilibrium condition, we can say in two sector economy as y equals okay, let's discuss these things later. Yeah, C plus I. This is first scenario. And also, when it's become a economy, all the in equilibrium injections should be equals to the withdrawals. Then when it's become a two-sector economy, already we discussed, we are having only one injection, that is investment. We can own this as I. Only one withdrawal we are having, we can know it as savings, that is S. So this is the second equilibrium condition of the economy. Okay, then we can see here how scenarios are happening in two sector economy. Households are providing, go through this, households are providing their economical factors to the business firms. Then they are providing, see here, target on my point. They are providing their economical factors to the business firms. Then firms are paying for them factor payments, wages, rent, interest, and profits. Then by using those, they are consuming goods and services which are provided by the firms. You can see here, savings are there. Through the financial markets, we are investing, we are savings in the banks. Then banks are doing investment to the firms again. Okay, then S equals to I. You can see the graph clearly. Okay, okay, then when it's become equilibrium calculations, we need to calculate particular equation for the consumption function. For that, you can see here, before go to the MPS, let's go to the sum. Here you have given in this graph, here you have given some income levels and the consumption levels of economy. Then normal way of the equation is C equals A plus BY. Here B refers to the MPS, that is known as marginal propensity to consume. අපි කියනවා වක්‍රයේ බෑවුම කියලා. එතකොට වක්‍රයේ බෑවුම ඔයාලා දැනටම දන්නවා කොහොමද ගණනය කරන්න කියලා. ඉල්ලුම් වක්‍රවලදී අපේම වක්‍රවලදී ඔයාලා මේක ගණනය කරලා තියෙනවා. Then marginal propensity of consumption can be, in case of here, we can calculate change in consumption divided by change in income. Metana n ekak mage erilla thiyena. Here A we can identify, A refers the consumption level when income becomes zero. මේකේ ආදායම බිඳුවක් වෙනකොට පරිභෝජන මට්ටම අපි මේ සමීකරණයේ A කියලා හඳුනා ගන්නවා. එතකොට මෙතන නම් 50යි. So we can identify that one. Or otherwise we can calculate MPC by delta C over delta Y. Delta C පරිභෝජනයේ සිද්ධ වෙච්ච වෙනස අපි බෙදනවා ආදායමේ සිද්ධ වෙච්ච වෙනසින්. මෙතන ගත්තොත් එහෙම පරිභෝජනයේ සිද්ධ වෙච්ච වෙනස පළවෙනි පොයින්ට් දෙක අතර ගත්තොත් එහෙම 50 ඉඳන් 200 දක්වා 150යි. ආදායම මේ වෙනකොට වෙනස් වෙලා තියෙනවා 200කින්. එතකොට 0.75යි. එහෙනම් y 0.7b 0.75, then we can put 0.75. A refers the consumption when income equals to zero, then C equals A plus 0.75 Y. If so, we know that Y becomes 0. And I mean, Y when what up 0 adesha karan, just substitute 0 behalf of this Y. Then we know when income equals to 0, consumption is 50. Then we can calculate A. Then A also 50. දැන් මේකේ බිංදුව දීලා තියෙන නිසා අපිට ඍජුවම ඔක 50 දාන්න පුළුවන්. එහෙම නැත්නම් අපි කරන්න ඕනේ ඔතන y වෙනුවට අපිට දීලා තියෙන දත්තයක් ආදේශ කරනවා. ඒ අවස්ථාවේදී consumption level එක ආදේශ කරනවා. අර ඉල්ලුම් වක්‍රේ සපීම වක්‍රේ develop කරන්න. ඒ විදිහට හදා ගන්න ඕනේ. හදලා බලන්න කොහොම කරත් ඒ 50 එනවා. Then the graph will be like this. If we graphically represent that, the graph will be like this. ओके मणिपत अभी एस वर्ट सर्विंग्स वर्ट इक्वेशन डेवलप करगन्न पुलुवा देन हियर यू हैव गिवन सम इनफॉरमेशन एहेम नत्तं ओयालट पुलुवा मुकद्द y इक्वल्स टू c प्लस s व्हेन इट्स बिकम अ टू सेक्टर इकोनॉमी व्हेन इट्स वेट in two sector economy y equals c plus s why I am saying that ai man ehema kiyanne man kiwwa aarthike kotasa kaadaayamen api paribhojaneeta yodawanawa mama gattot ehema mage aadaayamen ithuru tika mama ithuru karana ehenam mage aadaayama samaana wenawa paribhojaneeta kirima ituru then simply equal of s y minus c y වලින් c අඩු කරලා එහෙනම් අපේ කලින් එකේ අපි හදපු ගානේ මේකේ අපිට s හොයන්න ඕන නම් අපිට පුළුවන් s equals y minus fifty plus 0.75 y then s equals y minus 50 minus 0.75 y then s equals minus 50 y minus 0.75 y equals plus 0.25 y එනං s වලට අදාළ සමීකරණය මෙහෙම ගන්නත් පුළුවන් සරලව ඉතුරුම් වලට අදාළ සමීකරණය අපිට ගන්න පුළුවන් පරිභෝජනෙ මුළු y වලින් අඩු කරලා Or otherwise, we can follow up the same method. In such a scenario, we should have serving details. Me karagana mane me venagana kata dar vistar diila tiyenne. Eto kota iturum vakre bayum apita ganna puluwang iturum bala venasa bedala adayame venase. Ida passe eket sarala samikaranayak enne s equals a plus by. Then b equals marginal propensity to savings. Then we in this scenario මේ දීලා තියෙන ගණන් වල අපිට ගණනය කරන්න පුළුවන් savings 10 බෙදීම 100 එතකොට s equals a plus by නම් a ගන්න පුළුවන් බිංදුව ආදේශ කළ අර විදිහට එහෙම නැත්නම් දීලා තියෙන දත්තයක් ආදේශ කළා ගන්න පුළුවන් a මේ අපි අනිත් ඔක්කොම දන්නවා නම් අපිට විස්තර ටික ගන්න පුළුවන්. Then curve will be like this. When we are not having savings, when we are not having income, we cannot do the savings. Then when it's become zero level income, the savings become minus. That is practical. ආදායමක් නැතිකොට අපිට ඉතුරු කරන්න බෑ. එතකොට ආදායම් බිඳුවන මට්ටමේදී ඉතුරුන් තියෙන්නේ ඍණ. ආදායම යම්කිසි මට්ටමකට ආවට ඒ කියන්නේ මිනිසාගේ මූලික අවශ්‍යතාවයවත් අපේ මිනිසෙක් විදියට ඉන්න පුළුවන් මූලික අවශ්‍යතා ඉටු කරගන්න ආදායම් ප්‍රුප්නත් උනාට පස්සේ තමයි අපි ඉතුරුම් කරන්න පෙළඹෙන්නේ. ඒක සරලයි. Then here equilibrium income levels you can see. First condition is withdrawals equals to the injection. Second condition, y equals c plus i. Let's have a practice question. Api nikan sarala ganak katha karamu. Let's say me gana hada ganna. First example ganan dala ne meth ekak hada ganna. First example, let's say c equals 200 plus 0.8 y and I equals 600. මේ millions වලින් මේ දත්ත තියෙන්නේ කියලා ඔයාලා හිතන්න. Okay. Values are from millions. Then find out equilibrium. Income level. Then how to identify when it's become two sector economy? The condition we discussed here, one is y equals e, that means aggregate demand should be equals to the aggregate supply. That means simply income equals to the expenditure. Then in this scenario we can have the condition y equals c plus i. Then here y equals c 200 plus 0.8 y plus investment equals to 600. Then y equals 600 plus 200, 800. 800 plus 0.8 y. ආදායම කියලා කියන්නේ y. අපි y වල අගේ හොයාගන්න ඕනේ. Then we can get the value for y. Y උක්ත කරගන්න. මේ බිඳුවයි දශම අට මේ පැත්තට ගන්නවා. Y minus 0.8 y equals to the 800. Then y equals 0.2 y equals 800. Then y equals 800 divided by 0.2. හදලා කියන්න උත්තරේ. Tell me the answer. Okay, now you can talk. Tell me the answer. Okay, I'm saying that it's 4,000 millions. Yes, Iran sanchare kiwe hena mata mama denawa online sancharayak Iranayata online sancharayak mama ithi weda kata yutu salassanna oy hari uttare kiwwan me dawas wala airport wahala nisa online tama ekai yanne Okay, the answer is 4,000. Keep in mind 4,000 million. Then when it becomes three sector economy, අර මුලින්ම 2 sector economy එකේ sector දෙකයි තියෙන්නේ. ඒ කියන්නේ 2 sector එකේ there is 2 sector, the firms and the household. And when it becomes 3 sector, new party join, that is government. රජය මැදිහත් වෙනවා. රජය මැදිහත් වෙන්නේ කොහොමද? Let's see. The 3 sector economy includes three sectors, namely households, businesses, and the government. The addition of the government in an economy results in bringing two variables in an economy. These variables are government expenditure and taxation. Again, government හවුස්හෝල්ඩ් කුටුම්බය වලින් සහ ව්‍යාපාර ආයතන වලින් බදු ගහනවා. එතකොට රජයේ බදු වියදමක් එනවා. බදු ආදායමක් එනවා. ඒ සල්ලි රජ්‍ය ආර්ථිකයට මුදාහරි. එතකොට බදු ගෙවනකොට මොකද වෙන්නේ? ආර්ථිකයෙන් මුදල් ප්‍රමාණයක් පිටතට ගලාගෙන යනවා. That when it become taxation, something going out, that is withdrawals. Then government again reinvest those money to the economy as government expenditure. Then new two variables are coming into our scenarios as government expenditures and the taxation. Okay, then when it's become injection, government expenditure we have to identify as a injection, and taxation should be identified as a leakage or a withdrawals from the economy. You can see here. Now, go to this graph clearly. The government has come into the scenario. Then households are paying taxes. Then governments are purchasing goods and services. Banks are providing loans for the government. Then firms also paying taxations. Then there are some scenarios. Then under new conditions, we can have equilibrium conditions. Withdrawal should be equal to the injections. We are normally saying it as W equals to J. I can make investment to the Pavitan is a Tamai injection with the J. Kinaka Pavitan. Injection J. Kilagan. Then new scenario is tax. Then S plus T withdrawals, savings plus taxation should be equals to the investment plus government expenditure. Under second scenario, Y equals T. Then equilibrium condition can be developed as Y equals C plus I plus G. Okay, let's have an example. Let's say C equals 50 plus. Okay, C equals 50 plus 0.8. I am saying YD. I will go to the point YD. I will come to the point YD. Again, Vayakala Hakiyadan. That is that YD means disposable income. Difference between income and the disposable income. Okay. Then let's say investment equals to the investment equals to the 100, that means all are from millions, then G equals to D, T equals to the 75. Now, question is find out equilibrium level. When it become YD, disposable income, let's say business firms earnings their profit, based on that profit, no, let's say one person getting a salary, then from that salary they have to pay taxes, then income is that salary, but they cannot use whole of that income to the purchase of goods and services, because some percentage they have to pay as taxes. In that scenario, disposable income equals to income minus such taxes. Then YD equals to Y minus T. Got it? වයකලහක ආදායම සමාන වෙන්නේ ආදායමෙන් බදු අඩු කරා. දැන් සහන ආධාරයක් දෙනවනේ. දැන් හිතන්න අර 5000 දෙන්නේ. දැන් ඔයාලට ගෙදරට 5000 ග්‍රාම සේවක නෝන හරි ග්‍රාම සේවක මහත්ය හරි ඇවිල්ලා ගෙවන. එතකොට ඔයාලගේ වයකලහක ආදායම ඔයාලා මොකක් හරි කරලා ඔයාලට ආදායමක් ගෙදර පොලිටික විකුණලා ඔයාලට ආදායමක් ආවා නම් රුපියල් 500ක්. ඔයාලගේ වයකලහක ආදායම වෙන්නේ කීයද? 500යි සහනාධාර වශයෙන් හම්බෙච්ච 5000යි 5500. මොකෙන් ඔයාලට බත් ගෙවන්න කියනවා 100ක්. එහෙනම් 5500 න් අඩු කරනවා 100ක් 5400. Let's say you have given a subsidy of 5000, you have earned an income of 500, then your disposable income becomes 500 plus 5000. That means income plus that subsidy, that means 5500. Let's say you also have to pay a tax also, then deduct taxation, that means 500 plus 5000 minus 100. I think you got the point. Okay, here no subsidy scenarios, metana tax subsidies thiyena kiyala ne. Okay, then first scenario api kalin eke okay before that go to the first sub kalingane can you develop equation for s savings wala equation ek gan I told you how to do it savings equals to Y minus C, then savings equals to Y minus C equals to 200 plus 0.8 Y, then S equals to Y minus 200 minus 0.8 Y, then S equals to minus 200 plus 0.2 Y. Okay, then second condition of our equilibrium, when it's become two sector economy ke condition ne kama kadda W equals to J. When it's become two sector economy, S equals to I investment. Then savings equals to, as we calculated here, minus 200 plus 0.2 Y equals to investment kiya da gaane 600. Nah. හදන්න බලන්න again we may get 0.2 equals to 600 minus 200 එහා පැත්තට යද්දි plus 200 0.2y then y equals 800 divided by 0.2 that means y equals again 4000 million got it okay now let's do this one first equilibrium condition is y equals when it's become a two sector economy c plus I plus g then y equals 50 plus 0.8 yd yd වලින් y ගන්න yd equals to what මං කිව්වා yd කොහමද y minus t plus tr අපි tr කියමු subsidies වලට එහෙනම් subsidies මතන නැති නිසා y minus t t කීයද 75 e කියලා දාලා තියෙන්නේ taxation මතක තියාගන්න 75 plus investment 100 plus government expenditure again 75 then y equals වරන් අයින් කරගෙන යමු 50 plus 0.8 y plus හත්ත පහ ගුණ කරලා කියන්න සිංහල බිංදු දශම අටේ තියද කියන්න මේක කරන්න එපා කතා කරන්න okay 60 then yes it's minus minus 60 plus 100 plus 75 then you can get y to the left side that means plus එක අනිත් පැත්තට ගන්න y minus 0.8 y equals to 50 50න් 60ක් ගියාම ඍණ 10යි ඍණ 10යි 100යි 90යි 90යි 75යි 165යි 165 then 0.2y equals to 165 then equals to 165 divided by 0.2 y equals to කීයද
yeah.
825 825යි ඉන්ඩීසින් කියන්නේ කොට් වෙනවා 125 that means million million
1825 million
million okay ඕකම හදන්න බලන්න w equals j condition එකේ අපි ගමු s වලට equation එකක් ඉස්සල්ලා equals y minus c then here s equals y minus c kill c 50 plus 0.8 yd එහෙනම් yd එක ඇතුලේ ආයෙත් අපි y හදා ගන්න ඕනේ then 0.8 y minus x කියලා ඇත්ත බහිනේ 75 දැන් ගන්න s equals y minus minus 50 අපි ඇතුළ වරහන් ඇතුළ අයින් කරගන්න ඕනි ඉස්සෙල්ල 50 plus 0.8 y minus 75 බිංදුව දශම අටේ 60යිද 60යි නේ 75 into 0.8 4
minus 60
60 minus 60 then then we can have s equals y minus 50 minus 0.8 y minus into minus plus
60 yes
arinel then s equals plus එකක් එනවා plus 10 plus 0.8 y අපි හදලා බලමු okay then our condition is w equals to j then here you can see s plus t then 10 plus 0.8 y plus x 75 equals injections I plus G I how much I 100 G 75 100 plus 75 that means here 85 plus 0.8 y equals 175 then 0.2 ne s equals 0.2 0.2 y equals 175 minus 85 වෙනස් වෙනවද check we have wrong හදලා බලන්න y minus c hari y minus 50 plus 0.60 හරි s හරිද බලන්න s එක හරිද කියලා අපි අරන් තියෙනවා. වැඩේ එක කොහේ හරි අවුලක් ඇති. But the thing is scenario is this. දෙකම එකම උත්තර දුන්නා. You should have one same answer. But here okay. Okay. Then let's take 0.2y. Then we can get y equals 175 minus 85 equals 90. 90 divided by 0.2. Then y. उत्तर देखें हदला then we can move to the four sector economy. This is what we are practically seeing in the world. After 1970s we are also experiencing this. There are some positive and negative things to discuss, but this is not the time to it. Four sector open economy. Okay, when it's become a four sector economy, in three sector economy we had household sector, business sector and government sector. When it's become four sector economy, we are having the international sector. Circular flow of income in four sector economy consists of households, firms, government and foreign sector. You can see clearly in this graph, you can see now when it's become four sectors, what is actually happening? The households are going to purchase goods and services not only from the Sri Lankan firms but also from the foreign firms too, that is known as exports. And also Sri Lankan business firms also can target not only the consumers of who are live within the country but also the consumers from the foreign countries also. Then all the things have been clearly mentioned here. Then national income condition we can develop C plus, I plus, G plus within bracket X minus M, that means net exports. Then when it's become leakages, withdrawals, we may have in three ape salli pitratata gala gena yana okane apita vela thiyena ape salli pitratata gala gena yamana walakwa gannone mokak imports servings taxation and imports becomes the withdrawals or the leakages. Then in injections we can see investment, government spending or government expenditure and the exports. Pitrata minissu ape baanna me. Ethoda pitrata salli circular ekem pita salli circular ekata. Here it has been mentioned. Okay. Okay. From that part also let's do a practice question. Then let's say No practice questions available. Yeah, I will upload one practice question from that part also. Then that's all. Then what you need to do, this from this part, few past paper questions have been asked. Please go through those and try whether you are capable to do those past paper questions. Okay.